Hi, welcome to this new video tutorial. Today I'm going to show you how you can add your information page on top menu in OpenCart. This one without using any extensions. So this one can be the information page or any existing public page that you have in your OpenCart. So how to do that? Let's go directly to the browser. So if you go to our browser here, here is for example our store, and here on this top menu we would like to put here about us and also put here contact us, right? And this can be any other information, so it can be also information like this one, brands, returns, policy. So how do we do that? So in this example here, we are going to add this about us here in the first menu, in the first positions here, and also add contact us in the last positions here. So this is what we are trying to achieve. And so it's just what we are trying to achieve, but here we have, this is the case where we have a single language. So I will work with this case first, and then later on I will show you how we can do this one with multiple language. So that said, what do we have to modify? And remember that in OpenCart 3.x, we have a tweak instead of the old TPL templates. So this one is based on the OpenCart 3 and more. I don't know what will be in the future version, but this one is based on OpenCart 3. So you go to your local host and here upload. Then we go to system. We go here to catalog. Because here the information here will be here in the catalog here. So we go to the catalog, of course, then view, theme, default, and template. And here in template here we are presented with common. Then in common here we go to menu, then we are going to open this menu. Then when we open this menu here, then what we want to do is we want about us to appear in the first position. So just after this tab UL tag here, we are going to put the first link. Right, so we put the first link here. We are going to uncomment this one and we save it. So what we do here is to add this small HTML listing. So this li tag, then the link, and this link here is the link of your information page. So suppose where you access your information page, the information page appearing here, so let's undo a bit. So we undo everything, go back again to our page, and if you come down here, this is about us. If we click here, so we are going to take this URL here, this is what we take. And remember this one, this part here will vary depending on your existing URL here. It will depend here in local also, and here it may vary. If you are hosted, it will be www something. So you have to be careful about this this part here. And yeah, this is what we copy here, and our information ID page for about us is 4. So we copy that entire things, come here, and we paste it. and we put the name that we want to use here. So whenever someone will click on About Us, it will go directly to this page, right? So if we do that, remember here, in the very bottom here, it's in line 9, just after the navigations. If we save that and go to our URL, bam, you see About Us appearing here. It's appearing here. And same thing you want to do for Contact Us, and this one should appear at the end here. So in order to do that, we have to go again here. This is almost in line 27. So after and before closing this navigations, we are going to put that. And this one is very important. So we put it here and we remove the comments. Same thing as we did as before, you are going to copy that URL and put it here inside this tag, and then you put the name of what you want to appear there is Contact Us. If we save it, right, if we save it and refresh, you can see that now, right now you see About Us, and when you click here, it goes to Contact Us, and here we still have our category. So this is how we simply add this thing without using any extra extensions. And now the problem remains here. If you have a single language, then this tutorial will be good for you. But whenever we click here, for example, on French, you can see that everything changed here to French, except these two. So we need to find a way how to do this one, and this one will be the objects of my next tutorial. I will prepare another tutorial how we can put some conditions here to check when this language change and add them accordingly. See, that's it. Stay tuned for the next video tutorial. Bye.